The cyber kingdom is thriving, with better detection and more defenses than ever before. My name is Matt, and this season of the game, we're asking, who can you trust? Because the safety of the castle isn't just about what sort of protections you have in place. It's about how everyone in, around, and connected to your castle behaves. In cybersecurity, we refer to this as user behaviour.
User behaviour is the things that we do. The things that we, as people using technology and cyber, actually do. You are a user. What you do and how you behave actually determines how safe you are. The reason that your behaviour is important is because you hold the keys to your kingdom. And if you give somebody the keys, then they can come in and do whatever they want in your castle.
Cybersecurity awareness is teaching people, so you, the users, how to best protect themselves online. It's to identify behavior that's not normal. So things that you should, oh, there's a light bulb, this isn't normal, I should report this. So if you can have the knowledge to do that quickly and to know what to do when you see this, really helps your cybersecurity posture.
We need everyone to learn about cybersecurity so that we don't fall prey to cyber trickery.
Trickery is people or things pretending to be something that they're not.
Trickery in cybersecurity is trying to convince someone to act in a certain way that's not accepted.
Take, for example, somebody sending you an email saying they're a really rich prince and they're going to give you lots of money if you do things for them. They might not really be a prince and they might not give you any money, but they're trying to lure you in and make you do things that you shouldn't do.
In my job, I encounter all sorts of cyber trickery.
Threat actors pretending to be a valid site, a login page, or pretending to be a real person who actually is a compromised account, and try and get information from whoever they're engaging with.
So the biggest defense around cyber trickery is being curious, asking questions, being a little bit skeptical, and knowing and being aware of what's going on around you.
Around every corner, there is a new problem to solve, a new threat to stop. It really makes you wonder, can I trust anyone?
There's this really cool term that has really taken off in cyber over the last couple of years, zero trust.
Zero trust in cybersecurity refers to a system where you can validate and check people's credentials and make sure that they only have access to things that they need to do their job.
What that really means is that we don't trust anyone until they prove that they can be trusted.
In my mind, when I think about zero trust, it is trust nothing, trust nobody, and verify first.
Assume that people out there will do the wrong thing, either intentionally or by accident. And if you assume that that will happen and that you need to take steps to prevent it, then you're applying the principles of zero trust.
Zero trust in the real world is something that you already do. You don't leave your school bag lying around so that other people can get to it or what's in your school bag. Zero trust is about doing the exact same thing in the digital world.
Those foxes are very clever. If you're going to stay one step ahead, you need to ask yourself, who can you trust?